online conveyancing. Now, guys, come 1st of July, New South Wales Law Society are letting us know that the contract for the sale of purchase and land will be online. It will be e-conveyancing from that point onwards. So we're hoping that that's the date, and certainly the date that's being said at the moment. So, but even if it's not the 1st of July, it will certainly be coming along sometime very soon. Now, from an agent's point of view, there's not a lot different for you. Yes, you need to get good at DocuSign, so get in there, have a look at it, make sure you're comfortable with how it uses, particularly if you are an auction agency, make sure that you've got all of that sorted on how you might do that on-site as well as if you do in-rooms auctions, and make sure that you have DocuSign well and truly down pat in terms of how you use it and the staff member who will be facilitating that on the day. But guys, when you're actually talking to your vendors and you're talking about yes, you need a contract, and explaining to them the legalities around needing a contract in order for them to sell their property, residential property obviously needs it before you start marketing, then perhaps one of the things you need to say to them is make sure they are choosing a solicitor. Now, you're not necessarily giving them the names of solicitors, whilst you can give them suggestions. It might just be make sure that you ask your solicitor the questions. Are they experienced in doing e-conveyancing? Are they PEXA registered or registered to do that? You don't need to even remember the name PEXA. Not bad if you do, but you know, just check that they're able to do it and check that they have an understanding. So, because it could well slow down the process if they're working with a solicitor that is not competent in that area or experienced. And, you know, some solicitors have been doing it for a while, some have not. And there are some solicitors that don't like computers, so this is going to be a real challenge for them, and they're going to have to outsource that to bodies that will do it for them. So from your point of view as a salesperson, you don't need this to slow down. You need exchanges to happen. You need settlements to proceed smoothly. So guys, just talk to your vendors and make it part of the chat that you have with them about you providing a good service. Hey guys, make sure you make that right decision. So to your vendor, Mr. and Mrs. Vendor, Mr. and Mrs. Vendor, whoever your vendor is, just make sure that you're giving them that little bit of advice. Ask some questions of your solicitor or conveyancer and make sure that they are really good and experienced in doing this. That's all I wanted to say about online conveyancing. We say plenty more about it in our CPD course this year, and go into, you know, the details of what you need to understand from an agent's perspective.